The filling or restorative materials for simple dental caries were earlier basically metals or alloys of those metals. Later, more aesthetic materials such as cements and resins evolved, glass ionomer cement being one among them. GIC is the generic name for materials based on the reaction of glass powder and polyacrylic acid. GICs have been used for many purposes, including aesthetic restoration of anterior teeth, example class 3 and 5 sites, as luting cements and as adhesives for orthodontic appliances and intermediate restorations, and as also pit and fissure sealants, liners and bases, and as core build-up materials. The GICs are classified based on their function. Type 1 is basically the cement which is used for luting, crowns, bridges and orthodontic brackets. Type 2A is the cement which is usually the aesthetic restorative cement. Type 2B is the reinforced restorative cement. Then type 3 is the lining cement or the cement which is used as the base. So what does GIC contain? It has a powder and a liquid composition. The powder or the glass composition is basically made up of silica, calcia, alumina and fluoride. Barium and strontium or other high atomic number metal oxides are added to the glass to increase the radio opacity. The liquid composition originally consists of aqueous solutions of polyacrylic acid, which was about 40 to 50%, but such liquids were viscous and had a short shelf life because of the gelation property. Therefore, the current liquids used are copolymers of itaconic acid, malic acid or tricarboxylic acids. Tartaric acid is also known as the rate controlling additive in GIC liquid. Now let us see the setting reaction of the glass ionomer cement. When the powder and the liquid component are mixed for a GIC, the acid starts to dissolve the glass particle, releasing calcium, aluminium, sodium and fluoride ions. Water is basically the reaction medium. The polyacrylic acid chains are then cross-linked by the calcium ions. However, over the next 24 hours, the calcium ions are replaced by the aluminium ions. The sodium and the fluoride ions from the glass do not participate in the cross-linking. The cross-linking phase becomes hydrated over time as it matures. A silica-rich gel that is formed on the surface of the glass particle sheets the undissolved portion of the glass particles. Thus, let us see about the clinical manipulation of the cement. Remember two solid points under this. The surface of the tooth prepared should be clean and blotted dry. Then premature contact or exposure to the saliva should be avoided. Let's move to the surface preparation and material preparation. Under surface preparation, remember one point, the smear layer is going to be removed. How we'll remove the smear layer? Either using the pumice slurry or acid etching. If remaining dentin thickness is less than 0.5 mm, then calcium hydroxide liner is indicated. Regarding material preparation, the powder or liquid ratio is usually what the manufacturer mentions. Use a paper pad or a cool or dry glass slab can be used. The spatula preferred is usually a plastic or a gate spatula. Metals can be used rarely. The mixing time of the cement is usually less than 45 seconds. The powder should be incorporated rapidly into the liquid using a stiff spatula and mixed by folding the cement on itself until a uniform glossy appearance is achieved. Mechanism of adhesion is by chelation of the carboxylic groups of the polyacrylic acids with the calcium in the apatite of enamel and dentin. Let us see about the placement of the material into the cavity prepared. Initially, the material is slightly overfilled. Then remember, the freshly prepared GIC is hygroscopic in nature. Therefore, it is protected by a plastic mylar strip matrix for about 5 minutes. Then after removal of the strip, petrolatum, vaseline or varnish is placed. If protected, the material will not crease. The most important property is release of fluoride. GIC can elicit a greater pulpal reaction than zinc oxide regional cement. Considering the mechanical properties of GIC, the compressive strength is similar to that of the zinc phosphate cement. The modulus of elasticity is only about half of that of zinc phosphate cement. Thus, GIC is less stiff and more susceptible to elastic deformation. GIC restorations are also more vulnerable to wear and also less tough compared to other recently developed materials. To combat with these disadvantages of GIC, certain modifications have been announced, including metal reinforced glass ionomer cements, high viscosity glass ionomer cements, resin modified GICs, that is hybrid ionomer. We also have calcium aluminate glass ionomer cements and compomers. Let us see about these modifications in another video.